Now it's 6:35. We're keeping an eye on today with the stories you need to know. The American job market is recovering, but at a slow pace. Another 778,000 people filed for first-time unemployment benefits last week. That was more than economists were expecting, and it's the second straight week that first-time claims rose. The report also showed that the number of continued jobless claims was down from the previous week to 6.1 million. About 6,500 Atlanta Public School employees are thankful this morning that they will receive a $1,000 bonus next month that will go to active full-time employees and others who work at least 29 hours a week. The money will show up in their December 15th paychecks. Twitter is working on new guidelines for those who want the blue check mark next to their name. Accounts that will be eligible include users who work in news media, sports, nonprofits, and those described as influential individuals. Final policy is scheduled to be released on December 17th.
I'm Brittany Miller. I'm here at the Kroger on Piedmont Road. And on Thanksgiving Eve, we saw long lines all across grocery stores in Metro Atlanta. Take a look at this video from the Honey Baked Ham on Sandy Springs. People saying that there were long lines all throughout the day. People even lining up before the store actually opened. Now, in terms of store hours on Thanksgiving Day, we do know that Kroger's will stay open until 4 o'clock. We also know that public stores will be closed on Thanksgiving Day and the day after Thanksgiving.
The Butterball Turkey Helpline is staying busy. Dinner gatherings today are smaller. That means there are more first-time cooks looking for advice. Butterball says callers are asking for guidance on what size bird to buy and whether they should go with fresh or frozen. Another popular topic, how to prepare that turkey outside. As for size, Butterball recommends 2 pounds per person. That encourages lots of leftovers.